Hello everyone, this is Leon's America, and today we're playing a 3v3 on Napoleon Total War, and this is the Waterloo map with two Ottoman players played by myself over here and Scott. Scott's Knight 12 in the center, and then we have an Austrian army on the far right being played as by JustTheTip, and then we're playing against two French players and a British player who, he's pretty new at the game, so he broke the rules and brought a bunch of lights and militia, but we were kind of okay with it because lights aren't super effective on this map anyway unless you're poking over the ridge. So to start off with, we're killing some French lights that pushed up too far. Oh, those guys went nailed. Nope. You can see we already lost a ton of cav to artillery shells, but the rules were one artillery, no rockets or unicorns, and four lights. So both Scott and I brought some mortars, which are my favorite artillery in the game now. They have an accuracy of 10, but when they hit, they do so much damage, it's ridiculous. Let's see, I think we got a hit early on here. Yeah, we got a hit right there and over here. And France just somehow didn't shoot his guys in the back there. Oh man, these caps got wrecked though. So the French have artillery, a Pied, howitzers, and an experimental howitzer, which gets wrecked early on right here. Yeah, right here. Oh! Like I said, early on, when they hit, they do a ton of damage. And then Tip brought a foot artillery somewhere around here. Here it is. He brought an Austrian foot artillery. I think it's a 12-pounder. And then Scott brought four bashes. I brought two bashes and two Simets for this house fighting that was going to happen. So I'm going to fast forward just a little bit because I remember the fight doesn't pick up super fast. So right now we're killing some Emperor's Dragoons, which is an extremely expensive unit to lose for the French, but an awesome cav unit, so they're gonna try and run away. But I shot them a little bit, and I think these guys shoot them while they're running. No, maybe not. Looks like they just get a charge off on them, though. Kill a bunch, but they do survive. Alright, now I'm gonna fast forward a bit so we can get to the fight a bit. No, maybe not. This one does get close, though. No. Let's fast forward a little bit more. So you can see, oh, Dutch Grenadiers. These are the best-looking unit in the game, in my opinion. These guys? Oh my gosh, look at them. They're gorgeous. So, you can see they've garrisoned forces in all three of these houses. Dutch Shell Command? Nope. They have guys in all three of these houses, which is pretty standard for the Waterloo map. Oh, here it is, right? Right here? Nope. These two miss. That didn't kill anybody. I need to see this, it was beautiful. So they've garrisoned these houses, which usually or historically happened during the battle. And so we're gonna have to force them out of there, which is why I'm throwing out my Bashi Bazooks. But what sucks that I did this is they're already winded, plus they're gonna get shot on the way there. They're only facing fence holes, but you'll see they get pretty wrecked. Yeah, like I said, they're getting shot on the way here too. Oh, this is it. This has to be it. My guys are just getting massacred on the way in here. There's shells coming in above. Jeez, this looks awesome. Totally taking a screenshot of that. All these guys trying to rush in. Let's follow this guy in. Alright, so that's what's happening here. Elsewhere is just bombardment. These lights are being shelled. And so far, we've got a bunch of cav in reserve. I don't think I'm being shelled right now. But look how bad my guys are doing, and then the Polish Legion are going in. But, I mean, seriously, look how much damage they took. They're down to what? 75, just from two hits. Looks like a shell actually caught another one right there, too. is my cav. I think, yeah, I think that, no, this is Scott's cav. I didn't bring mounted Nizams. I think this is my general though, because I wanted to go rally these guys. Here comes a shell. I love it when these shells go off in the sky. It looks pretty awesome. Tip kept complaining about his artillery getting wrecked, but the reason why is because he brought 12 pounders. 12 pounders suck, Tip. He'll complain about that and argue with me later, but for now, we're all good. So right now I'm shooting these fencibles who were targeting the house with my rifles. I'm going to fire and then retreat so they can reload. Let's take a look at another look in this house here. Looks like most of my guys in this house died. Oh, look at this up here. Some guys died fighting for the staircase. Oh, they got up here too. Oh, they got all the way up to the third floor. That's pretty good. Here comes another mortar shell. Ooh, we hit. Oh my gosh. See, when I mean, they don't hit a lot. Like you can see a lot of them hit in the sky, but when they do hit, they do so much damage. Look at all those guys. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 kills from one hit. Howitzers don't usually do that much damage. Let's see. Oh yeah, this is... What I decided to do is sacrifice some units to get the fight going, because I didn't want to seem like I was camping. So what I'm going to do is throw up a unit of line infantry and some cav up this hill into a giant melee charge just to see if I can get some fighting going. And then over here I shoot some of his fencibles that push up too far. Ooh, that was close. Did that hit? Looked like it killed a hitting guy, I don't know. No, it's one of the guys that got launched back from the first hit, actually. So, it seems like Tip is pushing up some land where Scott's getting some cav shot up. I don't even know where they're going. Oh, he's probably going for all these lights, although they're going to get shot trying to get there. And there's stakes, so. Is that. Over here, I'm going for my rush. Although, the French guy sent over a bunch of old guard, because the British guy has no line infantry. All he has is stakes. Oh, look, there's some kills on horse guards. Alright, let's watch this attack here. I do hit the stakes right at the edge there. And then here comes my line infantry. The cav's just running amok right now. Oh, and then the British cav countercharges. Let's watch this charge up the hill by my line infantry. They're taking some shots on the way in though. I want to get a better view. Storm in the trenches. So this is where utter chaos ensues and the attack begins. Those are Scott's cav that just got shredded, but he took out the British artillery. And then Scott threw in some bashes into the house. Ooh, that was a nice fight. Now my guys are routing, getting massacred. Will the officer make it? Will the officer make it? Oh, okay, he didn't die. I think the guy behind him died. Look at all my guys that died for this. So that was the first assault, and you can already see the bodies are piling up on this bridge, and it's only gonna get worse. Over here, I ran up my general to keep his men's morale up a bit. And the British are returning to their lines. But every single second we play this battle, more and more mortar shells hit and get some kills. You can see there's just bodies kind of every once in a while. But every hit, every shot's getting a few kills, every volley. These guys need to turn around. They're missing it all. Oh, they're gonna get massacred. Oh. Ooh, did we get... We did. We got a hit over here. I think, yeah, both Scot and I are targeting the general. And you can see none of the shots are really getting hits on him. So it's not really like we're trying to kill him at all. We're just trying to hit the surrounding area. So we're bombing this entire area so that we can weaken them. Because this is where we plan on attacking. Most other areas of the battlefield are just a little too hard. Wow, looks like the Bashi Bazooks charged in here and got massacred. Look how few even got in there. But the Dutch Grenadiers fought them off. Look at these guys. Look just so good. I love the red and the little cufflinks and stuff. They look awesome. Oh, here I'm getting cav charged. I gotta get a good volley off before I got in there, though. So yeah, I just shot them up just before they got there. And then I sent some line infantry in. We took the house. I sent some line infantry in to support Scott's Bashi Bazooks. And that way they can shoot out of the house and stuff. So right now they're shooting these Lightfoot as they march back up this hill. Looks like he's sending them in the house, though. That's another reason why I should have brought line infantry. So that he could fight in the house is a lot better. Because his lights are just going to kind of get massacred. Because they're not very good at melee. But they do have bayonets. And these guys. So they'll be good at stabbing people. Oh, here comes a volley. Miss. Oh my gosh, look at that. This guy's got wrecked. Someone got launched back here somewhere. Here he is. Look how far he flew. The hit was right there and he went way over here. Jeez. I love the artillery hits in this game. Unless it's a round shot. That's just kind of, I don't know, a little boring, I guess. And this is a little shocking too, is that the British are fighting with the French. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but yeah, logic. Alright, it seems that I'm pushing up a bunch of units to claim the hill. That the old guard are waiting. It's not a good line of sight for us to shoot each other. I think I get a few shots on this rifle unit here. Nope, they're reloading. Open fire! Oh, here comes some more shells. Oh, look how close those were. Oh, this one did hit, though. Got four kills. This one missed. Although it seems to kill this guy over here. Might have killed the general unit. Oh, they hit. Look, they're just hitting right in between everyone, of course. Right here, I'm charging out of the house up the hill. So right now, I'm taking hits on this ridge here. But the ridge is keeping me from taking too heavy of losses. Here we go, the charge. Imagine if you were these men back here, just seeing these troops come flying over the hill, and then the artillery shells coming in. Oh, look at that. So these guys are just watching the front line collapse right now. They can't even see what's going on over there. They just see this little ridge kind of getting swarmed. Looks like I actually pulled... Oh yeah, the old guard forced me off the ridge. And I ran back in the house. These guys, though, I think I'm charging them and they're just going to get massacred. No, wait, no, I'm firing at someone. Yeah, they've been cut down. Ooh, look at this hit we got on the old guard. Oh, yes. I wish I saw that. I think I saw it in the live battle. Seems these guys took some hits from the mortars. Those are really concentrated, actually. So yeah, that attack failed, and the bodies are piling. And let me just tell you right now, from here all the way here, this whole box here is going to be nothing but bodies. Or maybe right around here, actually. It's going to be nothing but bodies soon. Almost nobody dies fighting for this area here. They all die going up there. So this is my cav. No, that's Tip's cav moving up. And this is Scott's cav. And the British cav are countercharging. I've got some line infantry running up along with Tip's cav. We're about to charge in. And then I'm getting all my guys out of the house to move up too. What are these guys doing? Oh, he just hit some stakes. Oh my gosh, I just blew my own guys up. I swear that was my mortar. Oh my god. Who's targeting what? No, we're targeting over there. That might have been the... Let's see what this guy's targeting. Yeah, it's their... Over here, I had to form square. They had horse guards and other cavs just kind of running around being crazy. Ooh, is that a hit on their lights? It was. How did that? Oh, it killed one guy. Okay. And here come the Janissaries. And these French cavs just like running all over the place. So look at, from a bird's eye view, just the chaos ensuing right now. This is my cav, by the way. I think I just got impaled. Oh, these rifles just got wrecked. And the Frenchman. Oh my gosh, my cav's going crazy right now. And you've got mortar shells coming in. It's just utter chaos right now. But you can see we have, like, no guys that are in range to support this. These guys are moving up, but they're not going to be there in time. These guys are going to rout because their morale is terrible. Like I said, this entire area is just going to be bodies. This is nothing. Nothing right now. Oh, look at that. Boom. There goes a square. That entire corner just got wrecked. Look at this, though. They have an accuracy of 10, and look at these hits that they're getting. All those guys just got wrecked. Going over here, somehow that didn't kill anybody. So you can see my swarm of guys has arrived. These two are right here, Scots units, actually. Actually, no, these all are. These aren't my units. These are all Scots. This is my unit here. The rest are all Scott's troops. And he's lined up to shoot all these dudes up here. Oh, there's a floating spear. Yep. Logic. So, all that's left of that huge charge is one of Tip's cav. Did that hit anybody? Nope. So you can see the old guard are coming up here to repel us again. I was telling Scott to use these guys as a meat shield, but he didn't really start moving them until it was a little too late, so these guys get pretty much wasted. The reason I wanted to use them as a meat shield is so that my line of tree could push up and not get wrecked. Plus, these guys take longer to kill since they are lights. It does look like he gets them out of there, though. Oh no, maybe he exchanges them, I'm not sure. Jeez, just look at this chaos. These guys just take a hit, they did. Look at this, it's just chaos right now. And the bodies are piling up. Let's see what's going on elsewhere. Pretty much nothing, it's all quiet. Once this attack failed, I don't think they really tried too hard over here. And then look at this, they tried to snipe my general, so I had to pull him back, and he's only got like 8 guys left, so thanks for that, guys. Tips brought over some Hungarian fusiliers. Oh, this is my unit here. I was trying to line them up, but he charged in his old guard. So, my guys are going to get wrecked. Nobody can really beat the old guard except for Samets and 47th Czech, which can fight pretty evenly with them. I think this is also my unit, I'm not sure. So you can see, even with Britain not having any line infantry, he's holding out pretty well. Actually, he doesn't have anything left, really, but because of his French allies, he's doing really well. Oops. Oh my gosh, what have I done? Oh, okay, yep. I broke the game. Ooh, did we hit right there? No. Whatever. Here. Oh. So here comes some more of my cav I charged in. I think that, yeah, that was our last one. Everyone was asking for cavs, so I sent them in, and then just like in the real Waterloo battle, instead of the British, it was the French who formed square and slaughter the the last of our cav here. They get caught in between them. Man, my cav just got slaughtered. Down 6 guys. So there's that, and then here come more old guard charging in. These units here are mine. They're really depleted though. These guys came back from routing thing. Oh, right in the face though. And look, the bodies are starting to really stack up. But they don't have a lot of reserves over here, so they are starting to crack. And the old guard are route. Oh no, those guys aren't routing. I think the other one routed though. These guys are just pulling back for now. We pulled all our guys out of the house since we were pretty keen on holding this ridge. Give some more cav. Oh, I sent some Mets over to this house. They get caught by this cav though, which was super disappointing. But it's because all he had was fencibles, and he actually pulls them out, which was pretty nice for me. Who's this? Musician, okay. And then they glitched out. I was trying to tell them to get in the house, but instead they just stand here and get kind of killed. But I do eventually get them in the house. Over here, the old guard were wrecking us on this ridge, so we just did a mass retreat. And you can see most of these casualties here are all red from, or dark, like red, violet from the Ottoman uniforms, and then the rest are all pretty much the Mets and Bashis, with a few British thrown in between, a ton of cav. So we're taking some pretty heavy losses trying to take this ridge, actually. I'm not sure. That's not my general. Mine's back here, hurting pretty badly. So here I finally got my guys in the house. They're down to 67 dudes, though, which isn't very good for a cement. They need their numbers. Oh, and the guy just disappeared right here. Alright, he actually disappeared. Okay, then. Look at that. I got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, 7 kills, and I lost like, how many of them? Like 40, 50 guys or something. Probably way more than that. Alright, this is Scott's unit who was shooting the ground on accident. Oh, I must have missed that. Tip got some of his Hungarian fusiliers massacred by the old guard up here in a melee charge. Look at this, there's just, oh my gosh. Both French players sent all their old guard over here. So there's 4 here now, there's a 5th one on the way. I'm pretty sure he has one more. Yeah, here's a 6th one. So we've got 6 old guard on the field still, and we haven't killed a single one. You can see we've got a bunch of troops formed up, but it's actually not a whole lot compared to what they have. It's fairly even, especially since they have all these other French units not too far away. Have I lost any guys over here? No, not yet. I'm gonna fast forward just a little bit. Ooh, is that a hit over here? Got like 1 kill. So we've got some lights in the house, not doing anything. Over here I get lined up so I can shoot these Polish legion. Because he's shooting the house, so he's not getting a lot of kills. Over here, okay, here's what we were thinking. We have all these guys here, but against Old Guard, these are all going to get massacred. And we realized they didn't really have a lot in the center, except for all these British troops, which are lights and militia, so they're not going to do too well. And we thought we could skirmish them down instead of using up all of our line right away. So, and we had tons of skirmishers, so we were like, okay, let's go with that. So what we did was we pushed up our lights and started picking away at him, and he actually came off the ridge to come face us, which is a huge help. I think this rifle unit gets massacred, if I remember correctly. I think these rifles shoot him. Oh. Somehow they're not getting massacred. Look at all the shots flying at them, and they're not really losing too many guys. Oh, okay, there was the painful volley. Over here, I'm still shooting this Polish Legion on the flank. And the whole time this is going on, oh, that's nice. Oh, look at that hit. Whole time this is going on, we're just pounding these French lines. Wait, that's not a old guard, that's Fusiliers. They've got four old guards. We did rout one of them, I think. Wait, one, two, three, four, five. Okay, yeah, so we did rout one old guard. Oh, wait, six. Okay, they do have all six. Oh my gosh. Would have been nice to know if we had at least killed one. This Bolshevik got wrecked pretty quick. And their little amount of guys on this ridge fell back. They're pretty depleted, actually. Oh, look at this hit. Oh my gosh. Okay, that unit just got destroyed. Look at all the chevrons we're getting on our mortars. Actually, these ones were upgraded already, because that's ridiculous. No wonder their accuracy is good. Mine, I upgraded like once, and they've already gotten like two chevrons, which means they're getting a ton of kills. Look at the casualties. Let's just zoom in. Let's follow this road. They should be holding this road. It's actually a pretty decent spot. If you could line up right here, you could just shoot my guys over there. Look at this guy. He died directly in a crater. So you can see they're opening fire on my guys while I push up to line up and return fire. But as always, we've got these mortar shells coming in. Doesn't seem like any of those got any decent hits there. These guys haven't even routed 11. Oh, that was a good hit though. Ooh, that one almost sniped their general unit. So over here, I've still got my Semets in the house, and then Scott threw in a line infantry. What I did, oh yeah, this part was awesome. So they sent in one of their old guard that was like at 120, almost untouched. They threw them in. I knew we were going to lose this because my guys were all depleted and line infantry were bad against old guard. So while they ran in, I threw my Semets at the door to stop them, and they just got massacred because I got a charge bonus off, plus these guys are shooting them from up here. Here we're just kind of skirmishing with them. As you can see, I'm kind of pushing up, firing, and then running back. Over here we've just been taking a pounding from their howitzer like the entire game. This guy Tip kept thinking these guys were doing a lot of damage, but they're round shots, so they don't actually do a whole lot. It's these howitzers that were killing a whole lot of people. So, their old guard's down to 36, my Semets are down to 40, and the line infantry that's currently in there's down to 77, but you see our morale's terrible because the old guard morale penalty. Over here we want to attack, but the old guard are close by. But we were thinking, because these guys are all militia, they're just like a soft sponge for us to penetrate through that way. And they're also kind of a meat shield for the old guard, so the old guard can't line up and shoot us effectively when all these guys are in the way. Ooh, these guys took a direct hits at some point. They lost 20 guys exactly. Oh, did that kill anybody? How did that not kill anybody? Anyway, now I'm charging my Semets up this hill for glory. Here they come, climbing the ridge. These Volturiers are getting ready. Their officer has a pistol. Let's see him fire. Come on, take your pistol back out. I saw it. Come on, fool. Take your pistol out. Or not. Alright then. I think I almost shot him. Take your pistol out. Do it, yes! He didn't shoot anybody. Oh, he did! He shot that guy! Oh my gosh. That was the officer, wasn't it? Is that the officer? No. Alright. Well, he shot someone. I'll take it. So I reach them, I get a charge bonus off and kill a bunch, but then I get routed. But look at this, their cav killed their own dudes here. Brought them down to 18. Did that get a kill? One guy, okay. So you can see both sides are kind of wearing each other down, but we have definitely got the numbers here. They just have the terrain and the quality of units. Look at this, nobody's dying from these shells somehow. I guess this guy died, okay. Poor soul. Look at his face. That's his ear, apparently. A pixel for an ear. Yes, we got a kill. Or wait, no, that sucks. He just disappeared. Alright then. I don't know why I was cheering for that. Oh, just got a direct hit on his lights. See what I mean? Like, they don't hit sometimes, but when they do, they just wreck people's lives. That guy had a family and now nothing. What is up with these guys? Looking at me funny, boy. Why is his face disappearing? There we go. No, forget it. I give up. Let's look at this guy's face. Or that guy, apparently. His eyeball. Here comes the Austrian army. Ooh, the canister. Imagine if you were these guys just approaching this hill. Canister coming down at you. And the old guard just giving you a glimpse of what's up there. You don't know what's up there, but then the old guard peek over and you realize the true fear of what's about to happen. Over here, Tip and my one unit peek the hill. Let's see if we can get some kills with these dudes. Nope. They decided to fire that way. Got a few kills. I decided to fire and pull back because I'm not going to get a whole lot of kills and I'm being outflanked. And they're not, Tip's not in immediate danger from these lines, so I'm going to pull back, reload, and then I'm going to try and push up again because I don't want his flank exposed. Look at this. They're firing over a plane of bodies. Over here, Tip's trying to shoot at these cannons, but I think he's being shot with canister shot in return. I really like to see these guys fire their canister. I think that's actually our volleys coming in. That is a howitzer, I'm not positive. Let's see. Nope, they're firing solid shot. Oh my gosh. Wow, those guys got wrecked. That's not mine. Scott actually doesn't have a lot left. Basically all of his guys in this house in that line of tree are basically all he has left. As well as the guy in this guys in that house there. So over here, my guys are all reloaded, so I'm gonna push them back up the ridge. Oh, that was so close. Or are these the Dutch? No. Oh, Fusiliers. These are all Scots infantry. Oh, they just got wrecked. Look at this, old guard just keeps charging back and forth. That's the third unit they were at. The first one was mine there. Then the Austrians, and now another Ottoman line. Oh, that looks awesome. Whoops. Look at all this chaos going on. Nice. I want one with artillery, a nice screenshot for the thumbnail, maybe with an artillery shell going off. Oh. Every time I push this ridge, I take more losses because I'm taking the first volley every time. Over here, Tip's trying to shoot this old guard in the flank. Oh, look at that. That would look awesome as the thumbnail, this house. Oh, well, I don't think there's enough bodies. We need more casualties. That looks cool. Nah. We need a good screenshot. Oh. I remember over here at some point, Scott shoots his own general. He doesn't kill him, but he shoots his own general as well as one of my lights that pulls back with one of his mortar shells. Whoa. We've got a volley coming in. Need to find a good place to take a screenshot. Right here looks good. Maybe even... Actually, that looked awesome right there. Let's do this. We need to see those shells come in. Oh, there's a hit. Yes. The screenshots are real. Get out of the way, camera. Aw, come on. Well, that kind of wasted it, because the smoke, or the battle camera got in the way. Let's watch these guys charge. Battle for this road here. Although my guys are just charging forward and gonna keep going to this light unit. Oh. Oh, there's good. I just missed a volley. That sucks. Our men are running for us. This my unit? This might be mine. I think most of these are mine, actually. No, those are Scots. This might be all Scots also. No, this one's mine. I remember this. Throwing him, trying to tie all these guys down. Cav wrecked a few of them, though. Like this poor soul. Oh my gosh, camera. There we go. Ugh. There we go. Ooh, there was a good hit. So the Moors are just constantly doing damage, and now that we push them back this far, we're just flooding in with units. That looks awesome, too. The Cav walking through the middle looks so cinematic, like they're messengers or something, trying to deliver notifications to their general about the impending flood of troops on this point of the battle. These guys have to shoot at Old Guard at a key position behind stakes, and they're getting nailed by artillery. So here I brought in a light unit. I'm pretty much out of line. I think I've got like maybe one. Nope, I'm completely out of line. All I have is lights. And surprisingly enough, they're actually gonna push us back again off the ridge. I'm pretty sure. All the shells come in. Yes! The screenshots are real. Who's my guy? No. Over here I saw that we were gonna lose this flank, so I fell back and reformed the line while these guys of Scott's units stalled these French troops. And let's see how many Old Guard they still have left. One. Looks like just two Old Guard. I can't believe we killed four Old Guard already. So here comes their charge over here. That or they'll just shoot me to death. I have no idea. Oh, I just got wrecked. Oh yeah, I remember this. I lost like 90 men from all this. Oh, and we're about to see the artillery hit over here that takes out Scott's general unit pretty badly. And we're being pushed off the ridge. These Austrian units just can't handle it. Alright, right here. Let's get ready to see this hit. Right here. Here we go. Where's my lights? My lights are here. My lights are gonna fall back and then the hit's gonna come in. I told him to charge because his general's coming. While I ran my lights, I told him to charge the enemy general. Here we go. Oh my gosh. Yes, that was the hit. I love seeing that. Scott blowing away his own unit and a bunch of my lights, and then look, they get charged anyway. So it was all a waste of time. And then Tip just goes in for this ballsy attack. Oh my gosh, this looks so cinematic. So the Archduke Charles Legion and the First Emperor's Own engage the French in a melee fight. and the bodies are still piling up. But look, there's like nothing left of either army. Basically all there is left is Austrians and French. All the Ottoman units are kind of dead at this point. And then my... No, these are Scots units that must have come back. All I have left is 1, 2, 3, 4 lights left. A general and my artillery, that's all I have left. And then Scott has 1, 2 lights, a line, two lights, two line, and an artillery. That's all he has left. Oh, did this one kill anybody? Nope, surprising actually. So the French are gonna fall back. We're gonna push this ridge again. I'm taking my rifles out of this house to go pick them off. Honestly, I think if they had held this ridge against us, they could have won this, but because they fall back, and yeah, I just said we win this. But yeah, so spoiler is that we win this. Anyway, I think if they had held this ridge, they would have beat us, but instead they fall back to this position back here, and they let us use our lights the way they're supposed to be, because me and Scott had no line left, so this gave us the advantage of using our range, and we just got an awesome hit right there. Love seeing these mortars hit. One time when Tip and I were playing our Cole, I got like a direct hit with my mortar on a foot guard from the Prussians, and like the entire center just disappeared, and the unit didn't reform, so there's just like a giant gap in them. So here I've got my rifles positioned on this ridge. The only good reason of being back here is that like you can see all these mortar shots are missing right now. And then their howitzer over there is pounding away at this house, but it's only 2% damage, so it's going to take their army quite a long time. But it looks like it took a hit in this corner and killed a bunch of these lights here. Alright, so over here I'm going to push up my rifles, try to fight some dudes. I'm going to fire a quick volley and then run. Yep, fire and then run, because the old guard are coming in. Another thing is that I think right around there is actually the very ridge of my range and Scott's range. So we can't even really fire at them because it's so inaccurate that most of our shots will hit us. Plus the farther the range is, the more inaccurate shots get. So we'll, instead of hitting at the very edge of our range, we'll be hitting like way back here or towards the middle where our units actually are. Well, Scott's going to keep firing over at this position on the far right of the French army, or the far left for them and far right for us, and try to weaken them a little more. But this ridge is kind of giving them some cover. Right now I'm trying to shoot their artillery, but I don't know, I wasn't getting a lot of kills. Well, let's fast forward, this is some small skirmish stuff. So right now, Tip's trying to push these French out of this forested position. Ooh, they took a few more losses there. Because you can see, I really want to kill these guys, but I just keep missing. And they're firing point blank and hitting me. These casualties. Look, you can point out all these different units. You've got Janissaries here, you've got Fencibles, you've got Hungarian Fusiliers, Bashi Bazooks, Polish Legion, Empress Dragoons, Rifles, Nizam Light Infantry, and you've got British Light Dragoons. Look at all these units that are just like, there's so many guys that died over this position. Over here I'm holding fire until he comes over this ridge so we can massacre these old guard. Ooh, the pistol. Yes, I love it. Oh, I took a few losses there. And Tip's got his landwehr still somehow, even though I saw them pushing up over here earlier in the battle. Yeah. But somehow I kept them alive. My morale is just garbage, and I don't want to move up my general because every time I did, they tried to snipe him. I still have a 6th Regiment Light Infantry over here. Scott's pushing up some of his lights on this ridge to go cover our flank against these Frenchies. And I'm firing on these Polish Legion from the flank, but the positioning isn't great because of this little mound here. Oh, direct hit. Oh my gosh! Did you see that? He just got wrecked by a cannonball. Oh my gosh. It just fired point blank and just like launched him while we were watching. I have no idea where that guy went. He just disappeared or something. That was amazing. Wish I knew where he landed. Is this him? This might be him right here. He might have been launched from all the way over there, all the way here. Oh, that hit me. But look at that. Howitzer shells got like, what, 3-4 kills? And then the mortar shells get like 20. As we saw here, that the old guard that lost exactly 20 guys. This is Scott's line infantry that's getting shot over here by the Swiss foot. I'm pushing up my lights over here. So you can see I got my lights on the front line and they're fighting the Voltigeurs as well as getting stray shots on these artillery pieds that are behind them. That's a lot of smoke. That was like 3 hits. I was wondering why that was so thick looking. Oh man, my lights are just getting cut down though, and my morale's garbage. Over here I put a unit right behind him to shoot this Swiss foot. I got a few kills, like 6. Since we're so close to their artillery, they're getting really good hits on us. And then you can see we have like nothing over here. Oh, the artillery is actually being charged. Better see this. Oh my gosh, flattened. Come on, let's see the other cannon fire. Shoot,
shoot.
Yes. Oh man, it's like a long range shotgun. Jeez, I'm glad I saw that. I didn't see that last time. What's going on over here? 47th Czech fighting the Dutch Grenadiers, yes. Oh, and the Dutch Grenadiers routed. This is my favorite unit. Going bye-bye. Over here, these lights go MVP. So they route the French lights. They route the artillery, and then they go on and route this one, next one over here. Look at that guy. He's trying to pick up his pace, huh? Oh, don't shoot me. Nice. Wow, that guy went flying. I love this grass. It looks awesome. Or maybe it's wheat, I'm not sure. This vegetation, whatever you want to call it. So you can see we've overrun all of their guns. But I'm about to get routed by these old guard that are charging in. Come on, route. Aw, the old guard's boosting the morale. What's this guy doing? Hey there. Alright, later noobs. Well, they almost routed this artillery. And they might even come back. They're down to 32, so they might come back, actually. You can see we pushed all the way through here, and now we've made a bubble. We've secured our position on this ridge, and the French have placed themselves in this farmhouse at the back of the map. This mine, it's not mine, this is Scott's. I think this is the last unit. Yeah, this is Scott's last unit other than his artillery over there. I think Tip's gonna start moving his single cannon, yeah, into position. So while that's all going on, we've just kind of surrounded this farmhouse, and we aren't letting them do anything there. They're kind of trapped in this little dip, crevice type thing below the ridge. So there's this like singular ridge, and then there's like a dip on both sides. I don't know why Scott's firing. Oh, I remember, he kept firing and hitting our own guys, and Tip and I were both yelling at him to stop firing, because, like I said, look how inaccurate it is. He's not even hitting anything, and he's just getting really close to hitting the 47th check over here. Looks like we finally... Nope, they've got one old guard there. Let's see if they have any other old guard. Nope, this last old guard just routed. He's the officer running in shame. The old guard have routed, sir. They're routing past the artillery guns here. All the Austrians take the field. The old guard in the back are getting stabbed to death. Oh, this guy's dead. Now these militia are in melee. Although all these Austrian units are very tired. We were surprised that these militia are actually gonna rout all these guys here. But it's because these guys are all really tired. You can see there's the colors of, on their hats. They wear the colors of the revolution because these are Revolutionary War or French Revolution units, so they've got those revolution colors on their hats to show that they support the revolution. Look at this, almost nailed my own guys. He ends up getting a direct hit, somehow not killing anyone. And that's when he finally decides to not shoot our guys. So this is my unit of light infantry. I'm trying to get to target these militia. I'm gonna fast forward, ends up slowing down a bit here. So right here, I decided to charge up my lights just because these guys were basically out of ammo. In fact, I think they both were. And I thought maybe I could mass route these guys because he's only got 26 Swiss foot and 39 volt years, so I'm gonna throw these guys in. Oh, yes, the pistol. Oh, he didn't get to fire though. And see, that guy's rushing it. That guy looks like he means business. Same with that guy in the back there. So you can see all my men are flooding in now. Oh, that guy got wrecked. Just stab him. And then they get swarmed by a Swiss foot coming in from the back. Alright, well, we're gonna fast forward again because it's just kind of slow paced right here, so I'll cut back when we're back into the fight. Alright, so real quick, a quick update here. Tip has brought up his singular cannon that was back there, and Scott brought up his mortar crew, which is actually heavily upgraded, so they're probably the best unit in melee out of all these units here. And now Tip's just going to open fire on the house and try to take it down. Oh, and they get wrecked by a cannonball. So yeah, there goes the building, and I'm gonna fast forward some more. So real quick, we're gonna fast forward while Tip's forces push up and do the final assault on these French troops. All I have left is my artillery crew and one light. That's the last unit. Yep, that's all of them. And that's the battle. And you can see I actually... We all got really terrible scores, but we were the attacking force. And all the opponents, except for this WTF guy, all got pretty bad scores. He actually got almost 2,000 kills, so he did really awesome. I got the most kills on my team, but I also took the most losses, mainly because I was on the attacking position, like the main area where we were fighting. And you can see here, my best unit was actually my mortar with 312 kills. So anyway, thanks guys for watching, and don't forget to kill yourselves, and I'll see you in the next one.